This is Ken Drews from the National Weather Service in Tucson. What's the monsoon going to be like this year? That's probably one of the most commonly heard questions around southeast Arizona at this time of year. This video will take a look at some of the key factors that go into making a precipitation forecast for the monsoon, which extends from June 15th through September 30th. While there are many factors to consider when making such a forecast, we'll consider three of the most common: ocean temperatures, current drought areas, and climate models. Warmer than normal temperatures in the equatorial Pacific Ocean, or El Niño, usually means a drier than normal monsoon for southeast Arizona, but not always. The current drought in parts of the western U.S. could actually lead to above normal rainfall for us. The longer-term climate computer simulations are indicating that a wetter monsoon is in the offing. We'll take a look at each of these factors in more detail in a minute or two. So how much rain is normal? Obviously, that depends on where you are exactly. In general, southern and eastern areas of southeast Arizona tend to get more rainfall than northern and western areas, and mountains tend to receive more rain than valleys. And in general, average rainfall ramps up as the summer progresses, peaking in July and August, and waning again in September. But this all varies from year to year. In this series of maps, heavier average rain amounts are indicated in orange and red, with those areas normally receiving 3 to 6 inches of rain during the month indicated. In this series of maps, the amount of rain that fell in 2014 is compared to average. Greens and blues indicate areas which received more rain than average for that particular month in 2014, while yellows and oranges show where it was drier than normal. July of last year was sort of hit and miss, while much of Cochise County and western Pima County received above average rainfall last August. Then, of course, there was September, when Norbert and Odile helped bring above normal rainfall to much of southeast Arizona. The relationship between El Niño and our monsoon is not as strong as it is when we are talking about winter precipitation, but by and large, the warmer temperatures in the equatorial Pacific, which are shown in orange on the graphic on the upper right, tend to lead to a drier summer in southeast Arizona. The flip side to that is the warmer temperatures tend to favor the development of a greater number of tropical storms and hurricanes in the eastern Pacific. If their moisture can make it this far north, southeast Arizona can get increased rainfall. This would usually take place in September, such as was the case last year. The graphic on the lower right shows that nearly all models are predicting a continuation of warm eastern Pacific Ocean temperatures into the coming winter. That could mean a wet winter for us, but for now, back to the monsoon. These tables show various cities across southeast Arizona and the number of years monsoon rainfall was either above, below, or near normal when an El Niño was present. Like was mentioned earlier, El Niño usually leads to a drier than normal monsoon, but other factors can come into play that cause this not to be a hard, fast rule. Another factor that can influence the monsoon is, believe it or not, drought. In order for monsoonal moisture to advance and persist as far north as Arizona, high pressure to our south needs to shift northward. While the high doesn't sit in the exact same location all summer long, it can favor one region over another for a number of weeks. The area of high pressure is really a dome of very warm air during the summer, and as such, tends to favor areas that have been persistently dry through the winter and spring. This year, much of the Intermountain West fits that description, as seen here by the drought monitor on the left and the mountain snowpack map on the right. If the area of high pressure favors the Great Basin, as in the simulation shown, a favorable flow of moisture into Arizona from the southeast could result, leading to more days with significant rainfall. A consensus of longer-term computer models are indicating that July, August, and September will end up wetter than normal across much of the western United States, including southeast Arizona, as shown in green in the top graphic. While the official outlook from the Climate Prediction Center is in general agreement with the climate models for a good portion of the Rockies and Southern Plains, in southeast Arizona, their forecast is not as clear-cut, calling for equal chances of a wet, dry, or near-average monsoon in some areas, and favoring above-average rainfall in Cochise, Graham, and Greenlee counties, as shown on the bottom map. Similar outlooks, not shown here, for the August through October period and the September through November period are more decidedly wet. In conclusion, all the factors that go into determining what kind of monsoon we'll have in southeast Arizona are not in complete agreement. As is usually the case, some areas will receive more rain than others throughout the monsoon, and certainly on any given day. However, there does seem to be some agreement that the latter half of the monsoon may be a bit wetter than the first part, like it was last year. Will that mean that we'll experience the widespread rainfall as a result of tropical cyclones again this year? Maybe, maybe not. But we should all be prepared for flash flooding and the dangers associated with thunderstorms during the monsoon. Thank you for listening to this presentation. For additional information about the monsoon, climate prediction, and monsoon safety, see the websites listed here. All of these are linked from the National Weather Service Tucson website, weather.gov/Tucson. Monsoon Safety Awareness Week is June 14th through the 19th this year, so stay tuned for more information and stay safe.